To enumerate, to call the object is an important part of combinatorics. To solve the many different types of problems, we have to call the object. So for example, we call the telephone number, the internet address, password on the system. So in this chapter, we consider the counting. So the counting arises throughout mathematics and computer science. In here, we consider the counting technique. And the first, we consider the basic principle of counting. We first present two basic counting principles, the product rule and the sum rule. So we consider the product rule. Suppose that a procedure can be broken down into a sequence of two tasks, task one, task two. We have N1 ways to complete the task one, and we have N2 ways to do the task two. So we have N1 multiply N way. So in a computer center, we have 32 microcomputers. Each microcomputer has 22 ports. Here the ports for the computer one. For computer two, we have also 22 ports. And then the last computer also have 22 ports. So by the product rule, we have the example two. Each block contain a sequence of three uppercase English followed by three digits. One letter, two letter, three letter. Then we have one digit, two digits, three digits. We can think this is task one, this is task two, and maybe this is task one, task two, task three. So here, task four, task five, task six. The procedure contain six tasks. So how many here? How many were here? And then we do a product. How many uppercase English letter? So here we have 26, and here 26, 26. We have 10 digits. So here 10, 10, 10. So this is the result. For the next example, how many one-to-one function from a set with m element to the n element? 1, 2, m. And here we have 1, 2, to n. 1-to-1, it means if A is not B, we have. So if here we map to here, and then we cannot map to here. In the third, we cannot map to 1, and we cannot map to 2. To do a map from A to B, we map 1, 2, m. Because here we have n, so we have n way to pick element in B for A1. So for A2, we have only n plus 1 way. So am, we have n minus minus m. So by the product rule, we have n multiply n minus 1 and then n minus m plus 1. Did you remember a n n here m? So here, a very exciting example. How many different subsets of a finite set? For example, here we have s, a, b, c. The power of s is the set of a, b, c, the set of two elements a and b, a and c, b, c. And the last we have a, b, c. The cardinality of the Bauer set means the number of on subset of s. We have it here. The cardinality of s is 3. So the cardinality of power is 8, means 2 power of 3. In general, the cardinality of the power of S is 2 power of the cardinality of S. And did you remember the bit graph representation of the set? We have here F, A, B, C. The number is 3. We use 1, 2, 3 bits. 0, 0, 0 means not A, not B, and not C. So the set here is empty. So if we pick 0, 0, 1, so we have the set C. 1, 0, 0, we have A. So the last is 1, 1, 1, A, B, C. We want to count how many subset here, because this is a one-to-one correspondence. So to obtain a bit string of length n, we have to solve for bit 1, for bit 2, and then 0 or 1 here, 0 or 1 here. Here we have two options for one bit, because we have n bit. So by the product rule, we have 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. So the reason is 2 power of n. This is the sum rule. We can done the task by n1 way to do TA and n2 way to do TB. So because this is all, so we have n1 plus n2 way to do the task. We have to choose a representative to a university committee. We can choose either a member of mathematics faculty or a student. We have 37 members, 83 students. By the sum rule, we have 120 work. We just choose one project. So we can choose from the first list, or we can choose one the second list, or from the third list. If we want to choose in the first list, we have 23 choice, and then 18 options, or 18 projections. By the sum rule, we have, if we use just the sum or just the product, we cannot solve many counting problems. We can use the complement rule. If we want to count here, how many? If we know the number of elements of S, we just count the complement. For example, 1, 2, 3. The number of elements of set, for example, 20. The result here is 20 minus 3, 70. This is the name of a variable. So the first case, we have the length of 2. And the second case, we have the length of just 1. How many options here? We have to focus on the condition, because we must begin with a liter. So here we have just 26. And here in the similar, we have here 26 liter. And the second condition must be different from the 5 string of 2. So we have to stretch 5. So the solution is, this is the number variable name in BASIC. For the next, the password is 6 to 8 character long. 6 character or 7 character or 8 character. Uppercase, letter, or a digit. The sum rule here, we can choose one of 36 characters for the first, maybe, and the last. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 26 power of 6. Let's focus on the condition. A password must contain at least one digit. In our password, the number of digits is greater than or equal to 1. I think here we use the complement rule. I wrote here the set of on password of 6 characters. We can split the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The first contain the password of 1 digit. The second contain the password of 2 digits. And the third contain the password of 6 digits. We missed the part of no digit. It's difficult to compute this part, so we use the complement rule. We compute just the cardinality of the password with no digit. 26 power of 6. So for 6 character, we have 26 power of 6 minus 26 power of 6. So here we have. So we have the solution. We want to count the number of internet addresses. We have 32-bit. We use from 1 to 7 for the net ID of the class A. We have a 7-bit, so 2 power of 7. From 8 to 31, we have 2 power of 24. For the net ID of the class B, from 2 to 15. So we have 2 16. So here, half ID of the class B, from the bit 16 to 31, 6. So the class C, from bit 3 to 23, we have here 2, 21. And the half ID, 2 power of 8. So we can use the sum rule. I'm sorry, here is. But we have several registers on addresses. The hot ID consisting of on 0 and on 1, we do not use in on class. So we have to subtract 2 and minus 2. Hot ID here, minus 2. In the first rejection, just for class A, in the net ID, we do not use this attraction. So here we have minus 1. This is the net ID and this is the hot ID. So we can use here the product rule and here the product rule. So we have it. About 3 billion